Hey folks, it's Abel, and I want to talk about doing large paintings. So it's a bit of a longer process, it's a little more difficult, it's a little more involved, and the first thing I gotta do is get my easel all set up. I can't do this on an overhead situation. I have to set it all up, and then I take a couple selfies because, you know, you got to do it when you get the good setup. And then I cue up the song. This one is Stolen by Dashboard Confessional, and I turn it on, and as I'm listening to it, I put my hair up so it doesn't get in the way because I got too much hair now. When I started this stuff, I had a pixie cut. It wasn't an issue, but now it is. And so I put my hair up and I listen to the song, and it just goes on as I'm working. And I pick out some colors that I'm seeing prominently in the song, and I just kind of get a feel for what I'm working with. I listen to it, I load up the colors that I know I'm really going to need. And it's really nice to just get myself an idea. I may need to reload the paints as I go, and I may find that there's some things that stand out to me that didn't initially as I keep listening to the song, and that's okay. The next thing I gotta do is just kind of launch into it. And I have to reload paint a few more times, and I have to hold on to a palette while I work, but other than that, it's not really too different than doing my usual paintings. I just listen to the song as I go, and it's on repeat because I'm not gonna get the whole thing done in one song because it is just too big of a canvas, too big of an area to work with, and it takes a hot minute to get these boys done. But they're really, really fun, and I get to work with something really cool that someone thought was good enough and important enough to them that they wanted to get something very large and quite frankly expensive to commemorate that song. And that's really, really beautiful. So even if it's not necessarily my own favorite song, it's really beautiful to me that someone loves this specific song enough that they want to get it commemorated in such a special way. And I really, really love that. One thing that is a little bit different when doing these larger paintings that I occasionally forget about is the fact that I am extremely small, and that has some issues when you do larger paintings like this. I need to have a stool in order to reach the taller parts of these paintings, because I'm very, very little, so that is a little different, but you know what? It's okie dokes. I don't mind at all. It makes me feel tall and it makes me feel cool.
We watch the season pull up its own last weekend of the last week before the gold and the glimmer have been replaced. Another sun-soaked season fades away. You have stolen my heart. You have stolen my heart. Invitation only, grand farewells. Crush the best one of the best ones. Queer liquor and cloudy eye. Too early to say goodnight. You have stolen my heart.
Sleep well.
You have
something that's also very important is that you take a couple stretch breaks and you don't hold on to your palette and just like stand at that painting all the whole while, because you need to take a quick break. Palettes get really heavy on your arm, and you gotta take a quick little break. You gotta stretch in between things. I know that this seems like I've only been going a minute because it's so sped up, but I've been going a second. And I like to give just a little bit of an assessment of what's going on and what I'm doing. And I like to just kind of take a second and evaluate the song just a little bit and kind of piece together what I want to do with the rest of it. The very last thing that I do is I take my little brush and I go around the edges. Now, this is something that is not going to be done by every single artist, but I really like to do it. I think it gives the painting a nice, polished, finished look. I like to just go up over the edges and kind of even out the paint up there, and generally there's a little bit of drippage from the painting itself. I will have to add a little bit of paint from my own palette and just kind of dab it on over the edges. I like to make sure that I just kind of brush it over smooth, make sure it's blended evenly, that it kind of lines up with the edges of the painting that's touching in color. So that way, like, one of the yellow spots, the edge of that yellow spot will continue to be yellow, or at the very least, it will flow into the colors that are next to it, and it just looks really nice and cohesive. Again, this is not something that every single artist does, but I really like the way it looks, as I like to hang my canvases without frames, and I think it just kind of lets it all tie together really, really nice. And that is how I do my large paintings. I hope that that was something interesting for you guys. I get a lot of questions about it, so I hope that it was real cool. I hope that you enjoyed that. Thank you so much. I'll see you again soon. Bye-bye. I would also like to take a second and thank all my Patreon supporters, Ashley, Nicole, Alexa, Ellen, Alex, Barry, Chelsea, Jenna, Artemis, and Alicia. Thank you guys so much for supporting me. I appreciate it so, so much. If that's something you want to do, go ahead and check out the link in the description. As always, thank you a whole bunch, and thank you for watching.